The people in Rampal Yadav's village had problems moving from one place to another as influential forces blocked a road. Pramod Kumar's seniority in service was dubiously handled by his school administration. Sanjay Prakash Singh, a life insurance corporation agent, paid the premium on behalf of his client to the corporation in good faith. The client refused to pay back. A transformer blew off in the village of Anjani Kumar Srivastav, causing a major electricity crisis. The fair price shop owner in Narendra Singh Chauhan's village acted arbitrarily to the inconvenience of all. Mohammad Akil Khan paid bid money at an auction of a plot of land. The bid money was not returned to him despite repeated requests. The GPF passbook of Guvaram Tripathi was not maintained as per official rules. Ramvati suffered as neither the GPF savings were released of her deceased husband nor the family pension. Dinesh Shukla spent sleepless nights as a goon encroached upon his land and constructed a house there. Problems are many and diverse. The list of grievances is endless and tends to grow constantly. The task before the government has been daunting. How can the grievances of thousands of people be redressed? Under the traditional system of governance, despite best efforts, the government was unable to provide timely relief to the affected. From the point of view of the aggrieved, there was little hope of finding succor. Poor follow-up systems on complaints made this position practically untenable. For rural people, another severe problem was that of accessibility to the government offices, which were the only sources of information for the public. These offices were almost always situated far away from the hub of the rural districts. And in the event of someone visiting these offices, the probability of getting the requisite information was extremely low. On the top of all these problems, if the administrative unit happened to be large and hugely populated, then redressing grievances of the populace appeared virtually impossible. District Sitapur in the state of Uttar Pradesh is one such large administrative unit. Situated on the Sarayan River bank along the Lucknow-Delhi National Highway No. 24, Sitapur is around 89 kilometers from Lucknow, the state capital. Given its size and population, bottlenecks were bound to creep in the administrative setup of Sitapur. Complaints piled up with no or little chance of disposal, despite the best efforts of the government. It was realized that the answer to all these problems lay in e-governance. Therefore, an e-governance project was conceptualized for Sitapur district in September 2004.
We did a study of two similar initiatives in Madhya Pradesh, in district Dhar of Gyandut, and Rajasthan district Jhalabad of Janmitra. And we tried to learn from whatever findings were there from those two studies, and then we made our own system, we developed our own software, and we launched it in December 2004 onwards. Initially, initially and even now, the most popular service is grievance redressal. Consumer must have a right to demand whatever grievance he has, what redressal has been done on that. So that way we were empowering the citizens, we were giving them their first right as in a democracy which they should have. So we named it Lokvani, that is the voice of the people.
A society by the name of Lokvani was set up so that the project could be implemented autonomously. With the help of technical knowledge provided by National Informatics Center, or NIC, 14 sites were launched on the 8th of November 2004 for pilot testing. The site of Lokvani became fully operational by December 10, 2004.
Project mein humne ye rakha hai ki jitne bhi hamare kiosks hain jo pehle se hi run kar rahe cyber cafes the unko hum logon ne license de diya. And we charged 1,000 to 2,000 rupees from them. And in return of that, we provided them the facility to provide the services available on Lokvani, and they can charge for it from the public. And we share some amount from them for the service they provide to the users. And we have all the we have rate list available.
The kiosk owners have profitably extended the Lokvani services to the masses. The Lokvani centers have also opened up employment opportunities.
Actually, I have got employment aur uske sath sath maine 5-6 logo ko aur employed kiya hai.
Information pertaining to various governmental departments has been made available to the Lokvani centers through a website hosted by the NIC Delhi web server. The centers have been given their respective login passwords to connect to the Lokvani website. Land records, arms license application status, general provident fund accounts of basic education teachers, and a multitude of other services are available online. Transparency in government functioning has been accorded utmost priority. Details of developmental works, ration allotment to fair price shop dealers, money sent to Gram Sabhas, and a number of other informative data can be seen simply by clicking the appropriate hyperlinks provided in the Lokvani site. The most popular service of Lokvani is the online public grievance redressal system. As on 1st of July 2007, out of a total of 94,273 complaints received, 89,742 have been disposed of. This is a prolific rate of disposal by any standards. The procedure that an aggrieved person has to follow in order to register his complaint in the Lokvani site is extremely simple. He can approach the nearest Lokvani center and convey his problem to the person in charge of the center, either in written or verbal form. The detailed complaint is then entered in the Lokvani site under the respective category of services. The category is chosen according to the nature of the complaint. The entries that are required to be made for registering a complaint are the center of registration, complainant's name, address, subject of the complaint, followed by the complaint. These entries must be made in the respective places in the online registration forms. At the end of the registration process, the complainant gets a complaint ID number, generated by default as part of the process. This number helps both the administration and the complainant for subsequent reference. Then the complainant is given a hard copy of the complaint with the nominal charges levied. Printout of each form is taken out within 24 hours and then forwarded to the office of the district magistrate for scrutiny. The Lokvani database keeps track of all the complaints filed by a particular Lokvani center. All complaints lodged through this site are monitored and sorted at the office of the district magistrate. Thereafter, the complaints are marked to the concerned officers. This is followed by determination of a period of redressal, which depends upon the nature of the complaint. It usually varies from 15 to 40 days for complete resolution. From the Lokvani head office, the registered complaint is forwarded to the respective authorities depending upon the nature of the complaint. Particulars of the officer to whom the complaint has been marked along with the deadline are uploaded on the server the next day. The users can access these pieces of information within 2 to 3 days of lodging the complaint. For accessing the complaint status, the complainant uses the ID number that was provided to him at the time of registration. A complainant may use one of the three ways to learn the status of action on his complaint: the interactive voice responsive system, simple SMS messages, or internet. The government officials download complaints on a daily basis and enter disposal reports online. Color schemes are used to depict the various stages of the action taken on a complaint. This makes the information easily understandable. Entries in red mean resolution is pending. Entries in green mean issue is resolved. And the entries in yellow mean complaint is in queue. The officer in charge of a unit is responsible for online monitoring of the status of complaints filed, pending, and resolved. With a view to examine the cases of default, the district magistrate or his nominee holds a meeting every Wednesday, demanding reasons for delay in redressal process from the defaulting officers. This system of weekly defaulters' meetings has made the officers extremely responsive to the needs of the people. The district magistrate is also responsible for judging the quality of redressals provided.
We used to randomly select 2 complaints and call the complainants also at the meeting. And we used to have a face-off between the department and the complainant to bring out the truth. That has reduced the number of such complaints, that the complaints are not being disposed of actually on the field. But still, we have a mechanism where we keep track of that there is qualitative aspect to the disposal of claims also.
A large number of people have successfully got their grievances redressed through Lokvani.
Lokvani mein darkhwast diya DM sahab inquiry ke liye wahan police ke paas bhejin jo hai. पुलिस ने लिख दिया ये रास्ता ये भूमि के ऊपर जो है तो केस चल रहा है. तो हमने दोबारा डीएम साहब को फिर दरख्वास्त दिया कि साहब पुलिस ने ये गलत किया है, इसमें कोई केस नहीं चल रहा है. तब जो है डीएम साहब फिर दोबारा इंक्वायरी की.
लोकवाणी इनविजन्स ऑलमोस्ट एवरी काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम.
नवंबर 79 में मैं लोली हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल में ट्रांसफ़र होकर के आया था. 2003 में जूनियर कर दिया गया, तो मैंने उसकी एक लोकवाणी की थी. तो हम आज पता करने फिर आए थे कि क्या हुआ हमारे उसका निस्तारण. तो भैया ने बताया कि हो गया है, तो उसी कॉपी आपके सामने हमने निकलवाई.
अनकॉमन ग्रीवेंसेस कैन आल्सो बी रिड्रेस्ड थ्रू लोकवाणी.
मैंने पिछली बार एक यहाँ विक्रम सिंह कमलापुर में तैनात थे, कांस्टेबल थे, तो उन्होंने बीमा एक कराया था. हमने उसको उसकी पॉलिसी कर दी, लेकिन उन्होंने पैसा मुझे नहीं दिया. कम से कम 1-2 महीने हो गए उन्होंने पैसा नहीं दिया. मैं कई बार तगादा किया लेकिन पैसा मुझे नहीं मिला. उसके बाद मैंने लोकवाणी की, तब उसका हल निकला. फिर सीओ जो है उसको बुला करके कहा कि या तो पैसा दीजिए या तो तुम्हारे खिलाफ जो है मुकदमा लिखवा देंगे. तो उसके बाद उसने पैसा दिया.
अ विलेज इकॉनमी could come to a standstill for the want of electricity. The problem, however, is not beyond the ambit of Lokvani.
क्या हमने शिकायत दर्ज करवाई? तुम्हारी शिकायत दर्ज कर ली गई. इसके बाद हम लोग जब चाहें यहीं बैठकर जानकारी भी कर सकते हैं कि हमारी शिकायत के फलस्वरूप उसमें क्या निर्णय लिया गया।
Supply of essentials can never be compromised with. Lokwani ensures free and fair dealings in fair price shops.
मिट्टी का तेल, खाद्यान्न, चावल वगैरह और जो चीनी वगैरह वहाँ पर जो है सरकारी रेट पर जो है मिलता था। उसके बाद जो है इसने जो है हमने कई बार इससे कहा दुकानदार से, दुकानदार ने जो है सुना नहीं। तो हमने जो है 2005 में जो है सिधौली में प्रथम लोकवाणी की, पर कारण बताओ नोटिस जारी हुआ कोटेदार के खिलाफ।
Revenue matters can often unsettle individuals. Thankfully, Lokwani takes care of these problems.
अपने खेत से मिली हुई जमीन नीलामी में हमने 96,000 रुपए की तहसील से लिया था। इसके बाद बोली एसडीएम साहब ने निरस्त कर दिया और निरस्त करने के बाद भी हमारा पैसा हमको नहीं वापस करा। इसके बाद फिर हमने तहसील दिवस में भी दरख्वास्त दिया अपना पैसा वापस करने के लिए, हमने कोर्ट से भी नोटिस दिया और मगर हमारा पैसा वापस हमको नहीं मिला। लोकवाणी में शिकायत करा और शिकायत में 2-3 शिकायतों के करने के बाद हमारा पैसा हमको पूरा मूल पैसा हमारा हमको वापस मिला।
Lokwani realizes that service matters can often be the source of tension.
मैंने एक Lokwani में प्रार्थना पत्र GPF पासबुक न बनने के संबंध में दिया था, जिसकी शिकायत संख्या 39761 है। उस शिकायत को करीब 2 माह हो गए थे। पहली बार तो उन्होंने पहले समय मांगा बनाने के लिए, उसके बाद में उन्होंने समय लेकर के 2 माह में हमारे प्रार्थना पत्र का निस्तारण सकुशल GPF पासबुक बना करके कर दिया।
It is the duty of any government to honor its deceased employees and their family members. Lokwani assures relief to the kith and kin of the deceased.
पिताजी की रेत 29 मई सन 4 को हुई थी और तब से मैं लगातार सीतापुर दौड़ता रहा अपने पैसे के बारे में, लेकिन वहाँ से कोई हल नहीं निकला। पैसा करीबन 7-8 महीने में दौड़ा। उसके बाद यहाँ मिश्रिक में लोकवाणी केंद्र जो खुला था उस पर हमने शिकायत दर्ज की, माता जी के द्वारा दर्ज कराई और करीबन 1 महीने बाद मार्च में हमारा पेमेंट आ गया।
Often the rich and powerful intrude into the rights of others. Fortunately, Lokwani stands firm as a remedial channel for the affected.
तालाब को पाटते हुए रामलोटन कहार आदि ने हमारे खेत पर अवैध कब्जा कर रखा था। तब मैंने जो है Lokwani द्वारा शिकायत की और उन लोगों से कब्जा छुड़वाया।
The Lokwani project has thus ushered in a new era of public-private partnership. Whereas on one hand, the Lokwani centers serve as effective links to governmental services for the citizens. On the other, they act as channels of profitability for the kiosk owners. Revenue generated by the centers is substantial and is likely to rise appreciably in the days to come. Lokwani sites have encouraged a number of entrepreneurs in opening up cyber cafes and single window facilities.
सिंगल विंडो का एक सेट है कि उसमें क्यों आप आयजात निवास प्रमाण पत्र जो पब्लिक पहले से लेखपाल के पास अपना अपना खुद जा के बनवाते थे, अभी इस सिस्टम के थ्रू हम ये उन्हें कोशिश देने की कोशिश करते हैं कि उन्हें दौड़ना ना पड़े बहुत ज़्यादा और यहाँ पे वो जमा करें फॉर्म, 1 हफ्ते का टाइम रहता है, उनको 1 हफ्ते के अंदर हम दे सकें।
Lokvani has widened the scope of e-governance, and soon there may be many more similar systems in place all over the country that could work both as individual systems and as a composite network.
And the future prospects, I think, will be when we merge this project with the Government of India NEGP scheme is of establishing 1 lakh common service centers throughout the country, out of which about 17,909 will be in UP.
With the bridging of the digital divide, the whole of the country could transform into a composite digital organism that solves its problems the e-way, slowly but steadily. The Lokvani project has triggered a digital revolution. A revolution that shall open the doors of prosperity for all and sundry.